Teeth treated with non-surgical endodontic treatment showed high survival rate after 5 years. So if you do RCT for the first time, it's around 90%. And if you redo, it's around 88%. Cohen also mentioned that non-surgical root canal treatment breaks up the success rate of 93%, 2 years post-operatively. Despite the high success and survival rate, the root canal treatment may fail when the treatment is carried out inadequately. There are some cases in which the treatment has followed high standards, yet still results in failure.
What?
So what causes root canal reinfections? There are many reasons why a tooth can have an infection after the root canal. These include the shape of root canals can be very complicated and areas of infection may go undetected in the first procedure, and your tooth could have narrow or curved canals that weren't fully cleaned and disinfected during the root canal treatment. Your tooth may also have extra accessory canals that could be housing bacteria which may reinfect the tooth. And if the placement of the crown or permanent restoration is delayed following treatment, it could allow harmful bacteria back into your tooth. And your tooth may get a new cavity after treatment or become cracked or damage, leading to new root canal infection. However, according to a cohort study by Yongjun Kwak et al. In 2019, if you have any of the characteristics below, your root canal treated teeth have a higher chance to last longer, at least for 5 years, which is being a female, less than 20 years of age, hospital as the institution type, lower teeth, front teeth, first time doing the root canal treatment, and the use of rubber dam. So here are some of the common signs and symptoms of root canal reinfection that mean you should schedule another visit to a dentist. Pain or discomfort ranging from mild tenderness to unbearable pain, especially when you apply pressure from eating or pressing on a tooth, or expose a tooth to extreme temperatures. Pus discharge that's greenish, yellowish, or otherwise discolored. Red, warm, swollen tissue near the tooth, especially the gums, under or around the tooth. In some cases, the swelling can affect your face and neck too. A bad taste in your mouth or a bad smell to your breath from infected tissue. If your root canal has been reinfected, there are 4 options that you can consider. The options are listed from the most ideal to the least ideal options. First is the non-surgical retreatment, where the dentist will remove the old root filling material and clean your canals again before sealing them up. The success rate is around 88% of a 2019 Korean cohort study, or 66% of success rate from Cohen. And second option is the surgical endodontics. It has a success rate of 92% using a modern approach, compared to 67.5% using a traditional approach, where a dentist may do a small operation to remove the root portion of your tooth, seal that up with some material, and stitch up the wound. And third option would be extraction, followed by the replacement option, where you can replace the missing tooth with implant, bridge, denture, or even do nothing. And the last option, which is the least favorable, is the implantation. Implantation is a process where the same tooth or another tooth is being removed, denerved, and placed on the extraction site. It may not be the most ideal option because it has its pros and cons, but it could be one of the choices to restore the chewing function for the patient. And that's all for today. If anything, do drop Brian queries in the comment box below. Till then, see you in my next episode.